morning children, welcome to today's section. Today's section is for second standard students. And here children, today I am back with a new lesson, that is unit 7, and the lesson is also 7th lesson, that is the ant and the dove. You all can open page number 17. Page number 17 in your test. Before that, here there is a small story in page number 16. See. Story reading yourself. You can see here this. This you can see. Story reading. Here there is no more work given children. You can see here. They have said. What they have asked. Read the story. Use words in place of pictures in. As you read the story and have fun. Yes. So here, Nutty and Mouse. Nutty is a mouse, but they have given the picture here. You have to write the name Mouse. He lived in a hole. Hollow. You can write here hole. Under the stairs. Huh? The picture you can see here they have given. Under the, 1 minute children. Here. Under the stairs of a house. He did not like to live in a hole. He did not want to eat cheese. He wanted to live outside on a tree like a bird. He wanted to eat what? Worms. Nutty Mouse got tired of his complaints. Then see what happened. He got tired of his complaints. The next. He wanted to eat a earthworm. That is complete. So one day she told him to go and live like a bird on a tree. Eat a earthworm. Mouse was very happy. He went out to the garden park and climbed up the tree. He went and sat on a tree branch. But when he looked down, up, he got scared. Then he saw a bird flying towards. He got scared. Then he saw a bird flying. He got scared. The bird knew where Mouse lived. It gently picked up in its feet and took him back to his hole under the stairs. He never complained to his mouse about anything again. So where there are pictures, there you have to write the names of the things, pictures given. Mouse, M-O-U-S-E, mouse. Then hole, H-O-L-E, hole. Then under the hole it is. Under the stairs. You can write like that way. House, picture of house is given. You have to write H-O-U-S-E, house. Then same again, under the stairs. And then cheese, C-H,
double E S E cheese. The tree E R double E tree. Then branch bird B R B I R D bird. Like this way you have to write the names in front of the pictures. Read the story. Use words in place of pictures as you read the story loudly. Have fun. So this was a small activity. You can do this activity in the home. Do the homework in page number 16. Homework. Page number 16. In page number 16, this is your home. So now we will go with the story. That is, the name of the story is what? The Ant and the Dove. Ant. Ant means what? Ant again and the kritiri kannadadalli. Kattirvi antirala? Yes. It is in small size. Yes, it is very small. Little bigger than. Little bigger it will be. It is small size of insects. So here, the dove. The dove means what? It is white in color. What color the dove is? The dove is white in color. So here, we will learn the story today. As you people have learned many different types of stories. The lion and the mouse. The monkey and the cap seller. These all how the monkeys trouble the cap seller. How the mouse troubled the lion. These all things you learnt. Today we are going to learn the new story. That is the ant and the dove. The new story is what here? The ant and the dove. So here, the ant and the dove. A little ant was moving on the grassy bank of a quiet stream. So there was a little ant. What was it? Ant. Ant. It was ant. Ant andre enu kattir. Black color it will be. Yes or no? So it was moving on the grassy bank of a quiet stream. Grassy. Grassy means everywhere you can see there was a grass near the water, near the river. We can find there was lots of grass. And there was a stream. Stream means where the water flows. Where the water flows. It was a hot day and the ant had been working very hard collecting food. Now she was thirsty. So see, when that ant was moving means what? Ali nadadartha hogudu adhen martta itu. It was moving on the bank of the river. Slowly it was walking. The ant is very small in size. It can walk fast? No. It was walking very slowly on the bank of the river. There were many mountains were there. And then many mountains were there, and there was lots of grass, and here the water was flowing, and here there was a big tree. What was that? A big tree was there. Here also we can find some grass beside the, and here all water was flowing, and here there were some branches on the tree. Yes, there is some branches on the tree. So these mountains were there, and it was very hot. Why? There was the sun. What was that? There was a sun. So what happened one day? There you can see a little ant was moving on the grassy bank of the white stream. I said if this is the stream. Stream, and here there was all grass. This is called grassy. Ella alayitu hull velthu grassy. So and that ant was moving on the grassy stream. It was hot day and the ant had been working very hard collecting food. And it was very hot. Hot day. Why hot day, children? Hot day. Why? Because when sun rays, the rays of the sun, it gives hotness. Yes or no? So here, the sun was very hot. The sun rays were very fast and it was very hot. And then the ant had been working very hard collecting the food. The ant was moving here and there in the grass. Why? To collect the food. It was moving here and there in the grass. And it was searching for the food to eat. So it was collecting food. To collect that food, it was working very hard. It was working very hard to collect the food. Now she was thirsty. So in this hot sun, she was in search of food. So when she was going on searching the food, and after collecting the food, she felt very thirsty. Why the ant felt very thirsty? Because it was very hot. It was very hot. When you play in hot, then when you move here and there, then what happens? You feel very thirsty. You come home, you tell, Mama, give one glass of water. Mama, give the water bottle. Why? Because you feel very thirsty. Thirsty andre eno? Neeradike. Neeradike ada yenattadu gantlela onattadu. Yes or no? Hashivu agodu bere. Thirsty agodu bere. Hashivige enanta kalitivi? Hungry antivi. In English. Thirsty. Neeradike enantivi? Thirsty antivi. Yes or no? So here the ant was also feeling very thirsty. It was feeling very thirsty. How clear and cool the water looks, she said to herself. I will lean over carefully and take a little sip. Then the water was flowing in the stream. Lots of water was flowing here, all everywhere. There was the water. Water was flowing here in the stream. Then what the ant said? How clear and cool the water looks. What the ant said? See the water. How clear it is. How cool it is looking. Here you can see in the picture they have shown. Yes? See the picture, children, here. Here you can see the water. This is the water. This is called as what? Stream. Stream. This is called as what? Stream. And these are mountains. This is grassy. What is this? This is the grassy. And here you can see the ant. So the ant was moving on the grassy bank of the river. And what the day was? The day was very hot. What the day was? The day was very hot. Then what the ant felt? The ant felt that I am very thirsty. Why? Because the ant was in search of the food. Then searching the food, the ant felt very thirsty. Then it saw the water flowing in the stream. Who saw? The ant. The ant saw that the water was flowing in the stream. Then what the ant decided? See, how clear and cool the water looks. The ant said, clear. Clear means what? You can underline the words, children, what I have written on the board. Clear and cool. Cool means what? Tampada neeru. Clear andre enu? Swachha tili neeru. So the ant was saying, this water is very clear and cool. And it looks, nodakke eshtu adu tiliyada, eshtu tampada anta kaanustada. It looks very clear and cool water. She said to herself. To whom she said? The ant. It said to herself only that the water is very clear and it is very cool. It will lean over carefully and take a little shape. Then the ant said, now I will go and I will lean in that water and very carefully and I will take a little shape. It said, I will take shape. Shape is what, children? Not ship, 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 a little ship. When you take a cold drinks or something, then your mama will tell, one by two. Neenu nimma akka ebru kudri vandradaga. Ava nivu em martu? You take one ship, then your sister will take one ship. Again you take one ship, then your sister will take. That is called a short ship. So same like that only. The ant said, because the ant is very small in size and more water is flowing here in the stream. So the ant said, slowly I will go from here, from the grass I will go near this water. And slowly, one sulpa lean, one sulpa bend agi, nanu neerana kudithinanta adu helutade. It will tell, the ant will tell, slowly I will lean over carefully. Carefully andre ati kaajinda nanu onchur bend agi neerana nanu kudithini. I will lean carefully and take a little sip of water. But the ant was very tiny and the stream was so big. But the ant was very tiny. Tiny means it was very small. The ant was very tiny and the stream was so big. And the stream was what? Very big in size. And here it fell into the water and got carried away deeper into the stream. So what happened? The ant, it went near that water and it wanted to drink little water. It went in water, suddenly it went inside the water only. Because it was very small in size and the water was flowing very fast. Then what happened? The ant, it got carried away deeper into the stream. Then the ant, it got carried away deeper, means it went inside the water and it was flowing very deeper, fast. Why? Because water doesn't stop flowing. The water will move fast. So in that move only, this ant also carried away deeper into the water, into the stream. So once again I'll read this. Listen to me. The little ant was moving on the grassy bank of a quiet stream. It was a hot day and the ant had been working very hard, collecting food. Now she was thirsty. How clear and cool the water looks, she said to herself. I will lean over carefully and take a little sip. But the ant was very tiny and the stream was so big. It fell into the water and got carried away deeper into the stream. So in this stanza, what we learnt, children? We learnt that there was a big stream and beside the stream there was the grass and there was a very big tree and the day was very hot. And the ant was searching in food. The ant was moving in search of the food. Then after collecting some food, the ant felt very thirsty. Then what the ant did? The ant looked near the stream. And in the stream, the water was flowing. The water was flowing. Though the ant was very small in size, it thought, I will lean very carefully in the water and have a sip of it. But suddenly, when the ant went near the stream to drink little water, suddenly the water flow was very fast and the flow carried away deeper the ant in the water. So here, help, help, how deep the water is, how quickly it moves. Then what the ant said, help, help, help is what? Kapan. The ant was shouting loudly, help, help, how deep the water is. It is saying, eshtu deep ide, eshtu talagade ide idu neeru. How deep the, because the ant is very small. Though the water is very less, but it will feel there is more water in the stream. Then the ant started shouting, "Help me, help me! How deep the water is! How quickly it moves!" Then the ant is saying, "How quickly? Quickly means very, is to beg up quickly. How quickly this water is moving? It moves. My, I will drown. I will drown means what? I will nan munugogtini. Munugodu. I will drown in that. I will get drawn into this water. So please help me." Who is telling this? The ant is asking help. Why? Because the ant is going deeper into the water. So the ant is shouting, "Please help me, help me." The ant is shouting, "How deep the water is, how quickly the water moves. My, I will drown. Is there no one who can help me?" She shouting. And the ant is saying, "Here nobody is there. Can hear my voice, who can come and help me? Yarara illidara, nan koogta idini, yarara bandu nannanna kaapadi." The ant is telling, "Help me, because I will get drawn into the water." A dove was sitting on a tree near the stream. So here, near the stream, here there was a big tree and here there was a branch, and on this branch a dove was sitting. Where it was sitting? It was sitting on the tree branch, and the ant was flowing inside the water. This ant was flowing in the water. Then this ant started shouting that, "Please help me, because I will get drawn into this water. This water is flowing very quickly. Is someone there who can help me?" The ant started shouting. Shouting andre vadrodu. The ant shouted. A dove was sitting on the tree near the stream. So there was a very big tree near that stream, and on that tree this dove was sitting. It was sitting on the branch of the tree. She heard the ant's cry for help. Then the ant was shouting to help me. So this dove heard that ant's cry. That cry for help. Why the ant was crying? It was crying because she wanted the help. She plucked a leaf from the tree and flew to where the ant was. Then what the dove did? As she was sitting on the tree, there were many leaves on the tree. Gidmele ele irthavalla varshtu elegalu iddu. Then what she did? She plucked the leaf from the tree. Plucked andre keeludu. Then leaf from the tree. She plucked the leaf from the tree and flew to where the ant was. The ant climbed on the leaf and floated safely back to the dry land. Then what happened? What the dove did? As it was sitting on the tree, it plucked one leaf from the tree. And what it did? It took that leaf in its mouth, in the beak. And then it went flying towards the ant, where the ant was there in the water. Here you can see how the dove is flying. It is helping. Here you can see, children, that it was sitting here on the tree. Then the ant went inside the water and it started shouting, "Help, help. Is there anyone who can hear my voice?" Then the ant, it heard the voice. It took the, see here you can see many leaves are there on the tree. It took one of the leaf from it and it flown to where the ant was. Here you can see. And
A dove was sitting on a tree near the stream. She heard the ant cry for help. She plucked a leaf from the tree and flew to where the ant was. So the dove came flying and it gave the leaf to the ant. Then what happened next? We will see now.
The ant climbed on the leaf and floated safely back to the dry land. Then what happened? The ant, it climbed on that leaf when the dove came flying, and when the dove gave the leaf, then the ant came and it climbed on that leaf and it came down safely back to the dry land, to the dry place. She dropped the leaf. Dropped means she left that, she was having that leaf on that, in the beak. And when she went, she flew and she went near that ant. And she gave that leaf to that ant. And the ant slowly, it sat, it came on that leaf. It climbed on that leaf and floated safely back to the dry land. Floated andre haradogu. Floated safely back to the dry land. Underline these words, children, whatever I have given. Thank you so much, dear dove, for saving my life today. Then after coming to the dry land, then the ant said, thank you so much, dear dove, for saving my life today. ನೀನು ಬಂದು ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಕಾಪಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಏನಾಗ್ತಿದ್ದೆ? ಸತ್ತು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡವ್. ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟ್? ಫಾರ್ ಸೇವಿಂಗ್ ಹರ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಫಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ. ದೆನ್ ದ ಆಂಟ್ ಸೇಡ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್? ದಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಫಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ. Maybe, just maybe, I will be able to help you someday. Then what the dove's aunt said to the dove? Maybe, I'm not sure. Maybe, avagladru, maybe. I may be able to help you someday. Avagladru vandina, nanu ninanna help madabahudu. Bahusha, maybe I may help you someday. Who said this? The ant said to whom? To the dove. A few weeks later, the ant was resting near the tree where the dove had built a nest. So a few weeks later, few weeks means salpa varadatra, or ella friends are bitidu. The dove and the ant, both of them, they have become very good friends. Then what happened? Few weeks later, the ant was resting near the tree where the dove had built the nest. The ant was resting. The ant was just resting under the tree. It was just sleeping. There was a big tree, and here the ant was resting here under the tree where the dove had built the nest. And here only up, the dove had built one nest. There was the nest on the tree. Good sir. Yes? The ant. Not the ant. Who had built the nest? The dove had built the nest. Who had built the nest? The dove. The dove had built the nest. There were 3 eggs in the nest. How many eggs were there, children? There were 3 eggs. What? How many eggs? 3 eggs were there in the nest. There were 3 eggs. 3 eggs in the nest. The dove was warming the eggs and surrounded very happy. The dove, it was sitting on the eggs and it was warming the eggs and surrounded very happily. And it was surrounded very, she was surrounding the eggs very happily. So till here I have explained you this, I have explained this lesson children. The next half lesson I will be continuing tomorrow. Once I will read this lesson, and your homework is you have to read this lesson today. The ant and the dove. A little ant was moving on the grassy bank of a quiet stream. It was hot day and the ant had been working very hard, collecting food. Now she was thirsty. How clear and cool the water looks, she said to herself. I will lean over carefully and take a little sip. But the ant was very tiny and the stream was so big. It fell into the water and got carried away deeper into the stream. Help, help! How deep the water is! How quickly it moves! My, my! I will drown it, drown! Is there no one who can help me? She shouted. A dove was sitting on a tree near the stream. She heard the ant's cry for help. She plucked a leaf from the tree and flew to where the ant was. She dropped the leaf near the ant. The ant climbed on the leaf and floated safely back to the dry land. Thank you so much, dear dove, for saving my life today. I will never forget what you have done for me. Maybe, just maybe, I will be able to help you someday. A few weeks later, the ant was resting near the tree where the dove had built a nest. There were three eggs in the nest. The dove was warming the eggs and surrounded very happily. So this was today half of the part that I have explained to people. Now next, I will be back with the next half of the lesson children. Till then, go through the lessons, read the words which are given on the boards. Don't write these words in your notebook. Idanna yaru barengilla, just idanna neevu odkobeku. Thank you children, have a great day.